Welcome to Final Cut Pro 10 in under 5 minutes. My name is Mark Spencer. Now for a real challenge. We'll look at how to key out a white background instead of a green screen. This is a video clip from iStockPhoto.com. Now, iStockPhoto.com has many clips shot on white like this one, which can present more of a challenge. In addition, this clip has also been heavily compressed. You'll find that it's almost impossible to create a good key. But let's see how far we can get. Final Cut Pro 10 includes a Luma keyer in the same keying category that is designed specifically to remove the lighter or darker parts of an image. However, I find that the keyer effect can actually do a better job on this kind of shot, since it contains all the tools in the Luma keyer and a few more to boot. Apply the keyer effect. The automatic settings don't work so well this time. Set the strength to 0. In the viewer, hold down the Shift key and drag a box on the white background. The white is very even, so it doesn't really matter where you draw the box or how large it is, as long as it doesn't touch any part of the woman, or else she'll disappear along with the background. There's still a lot of white in her hair. Hold down the Command key and drag an edge sample across her hair, and then adjust it. That's better, but there's still a lot of white. You may find as you adjust it that the woman's forehead turns gray since it's becoming transparent. Switch to the matte view. Increase the fill hole slider slightly to make the inside of the matte white. Then increase the edge distance slider all the way to get the detail back into the hair. Skim the clip. You may still see her teeth or her earring. Remember, we're keying out the brightest parts of the image, so her bright teeth and jewelry are getting keyed out as well. You aren't going to be able to fix those areas with the fill holes parameter, so let's hold off on that for now. Switch back to the composite view. In the color selection tools, you can try adjusting the Luma graph by dragging on the curve or on the lower handle. But using the edge sample in the viewer is more intuitive and does the same thing. Notice how the Luma graph changes as you adjust it. One thing the edge sample does not affect, however, is the Luma roll-off, so you can try adjusting that. But there's still a lot of white fringing around the hair. Close the color selection tools and open the matte tools. Set Shrink Expand to about -5 to shrink the matte. Then set Soften to about 1 and try a few different values for Erode. These settings introduce transparency to her hair, but at least they eliminate the white fringing. Close the matte tools. Spill suppression won't help here with the white background, so let's skip it and open Light Wrap. Set the amount to about 4. Okay, now switch to the matte view and skim the clip. You'll see by the black areas that we have all kinds of transparency we need to deal with. We'll attempt to create a holdout matte, a smaller all-white matte inside the main matte. Switch back to the composite view. Press the up arrow to move the playhead to the start of the clip. Press Command-C to copy, then press Option-V to paste as a connected clip. Select the connected clip, and in the inspector, increase fill holes to 10, and set the edge distance to 0 to create a solid white matte. Now, we need the matte to be smaller, so it's always inside the matte on the lower clip. In the matte tools, set Shrink Expand to -40. The slider won't go that far, so you either need to drag in the value field or type the value in. Set Soften to 10 and Erode to 10. If you skim the clip, you should now have a soft white blob, meaning that everything inside it should be fully opaque now. Switch to the composite view. Skim the clip. It's far from perfect, but we've managed to remove most of the white fringing and keep the core matte solid. Not bad for such a heavily compressed clip on a white background. To really make this key work, we'd need to keyframe the various parameters on almost a frame-by-frame basis.